Okay, let's make a spring tensioning system. If we go to the main assembly, you can see that it's situated on the back here. These are the registrators, and with these springs we can adjust how hard the registrators are being pulled back into their original position. And I designed this spring tension system in the beginning of my CADing career, and I want to redesign it completely from scratch now. Top spring tension. Create a new component. Beam. So we want the sides to fit perfectly into this slot. So I'm gonna measure the sides. 24 millimeter high, 50 millimeter. I'm gonna take a measurement from this face, this plane, over here. And then we got 864 millimeters. 864, I click it, it's copied to the clickboard. So then when I go to my new design, I can just paste it. Create sketch, and we put in the diameter that we just measured. Paste, 864, that's the length of our part. Let me put a kick drum to that. I'm going to split the beam in the whole middle and CNC two parts and sandwich them together. So this is 24 high. So I'm gonna make this part now the half of that, 12. So now we extrude it. I can assign our yellow color, that means plywood. So we're gonna have an M8 screw coming in from this side here. So we're gonna make a hole here for the threaded insert. We're only sketching half of the profile of the pilot hole. We can revolve this surface around this line, and then we can drill our hole from the same sketch. See? M8 threaded insert. Create a sketch, 12 millimeter, 12.5. I'm gonna click a joint. I'm gonna choose that circle. I'm gonna choose that circle. Now it joins perfectly. We flip it, and then we have our perfect joint. So you can see that this is still sticking out, which means that I made the wrong dimensions in the sketch because we don't want it to stick out. But since everything is constrained, I can just go into the sketch. I can add, that was 12 millimeter. Let's put 15. Everything changes, and since we made the mirror command, it will also change on the other side here. This is also 15 now. We can stop the sketch. This hole is 15 on both sides, and since we joined this, this has automatically pulled the threaded insert away from the surface. Isn't that cool? There. We take the mirror plane, is this. Voila, et voila, 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 voila. So that's our part. It's two identical parts, and we can make them from one single CNC operation. We can put these together with wood glue like this. However, I'm going to add some hardware into this. Let's throw some M6 in just for the hell of it. Let's say 10. 43.5 divided by 2. We can go back to the first extrude feature. We can just not extrude those circles. If I do that correctly, and since we've been mirroring the part, I have the holes in both parts. And just for test, I'm gonna insert this new component into our full assembly. Yes, there we are. But I can offset the joint by dragging this and entering the thickness of the frame, which is the dirty value of 9.525. Every time I have to put an imperial value in like that, I cringe a little, I have to say that. I feel a little bit dirty. Look at this, this looks awesome. And that the threaded insert sits in there. So we can go out from the steel frame with an M8 bolt and reach this threaded insert. And these kinds of parts of the marble machine X is also providing a lot of lateral stability for the side frame. An M6 washer. This is so satisfying. So let's join the washer here. Let's flip that joint so it's on the surface. Perfect. And already now I see that I want to shorten the screw. So I guess 5mm shorter screw would be optimal. And so now we have this screw design that we made earlier for 40mm. And if we did the drawings correctly, we only have to go into the first sketch. You see everything is constrained. We have to change this 40mm to 35. Boom. Stop sketch. Our screw is now 35mm. My doorbell plays Fidelis. I have that on my brain all the time. That looks so good. So good, so much better. And now a pattern. I just realized that we're gonna have a frame here, so the screws are gonna be quite close to the frame, which is not beautiful. If we did this correctly again, I will be able to move the screws inside with very small amount of effort. If we constrain the sketches properly. 21.75. Let's put 25 instead. And you see these screws followed because they were joined. This feature didn't follow. Let's remove the mirror command. And let's constrain it like this instead. Yes. Look here. Now, I have a function. If I hover over the constraint, it says D255. So, I can go out of here. I can go into my pattern feature. I want to edit this feature. This direction, I'm not going to put in a millimeter. I'm going to put in minus D255. I'm going to put in a function. Look at that. The screw knows where to go. Because this dimension has a function called D255. It has been giving that name. So if I, for example, now go in here and move the hole, we say I want it 10 millimeters away, then the screws are going to be next to each other when we stop the sketch. Look at that! Genius! That is cool. So everything goes back to how you build up your primary sketch. So let's put that back to 30. 814, D256 is the function. For this command, I don't want 410mm, I want D256. Boom, they're over there. D272, yes! This is so fun. This makes me feel smart.
Let me put a kick drum to that.
So instead of using the CAD models from the product catalog of hardware, I'm making my own placeholders for hardware because they have no threads and they are less graphics intensive. And in the full assembly with 10,000 screws, that makes a big difference for rendering times. So, my friends, after 2 hours of CADing, we went from this to this. It might look like there's no difference, but there are things under the surface that you have to take into account. This part fits the machine. This part didn't. This part is graphics non-intensive. And most of all, this part is easily CNC-able. I'm gonna isolate the bottom plate. So I've designed the whole part to be accessible with the CNC router bit from the top part. So you can see that the CNC will be able to cut this whole part out, and we make two of them and we sandwich them together, and we have a complex part with holes in different directions. If I then add all the hardware, this whole list of hardware will go straight into our bill of materials, so I know exactly what to order. We will never have to count anything by hand. We can extract that information from the computer. And if I ever want to go back and change something, remember how we did with all the functions, if we change the dimensions of this for any reason, I can go into this design file and change almost any number, and the screws and things will follow along. So it's like future safe. And if I now update the design, the newest version should enter. Okay, so what happened now is that you can see that all the springs ended up down here on the floor with some of the screws. So that's because of the joinery. So we have to go back. It's nothing wrong. Let's see if we can take this rigid group command and drag it way back in the end of the timeline without anything breaking. Yes. And now we have it in the end of the timeline. We can go edit rigid group, include child components. We save that into a new version. Now it's held together. We go back into the full assembly. Come on. Yes. The genius of this system is that we can adjust this without any tools. Just pull this out by hand, spin the nut with your other hand, and you leave it back in again. And the nut is locked by the plywood, and it can't spin because it's held in the hole here by the spring who can't spin. So there's the muting system, and it's starting to look like we're doing something right, I think. I love all this symmetry. And now also the marble tracks are coming in. Okay, so that was a little bit of a more in-depth hang along when I'm doing stuff on the marble machine X in CAD. So this was an example of, we already had one design, but since we learned so much during the project, I go back and redo stuff. And it's for the manufacturing process, and it's for the bill of material, so we can keep track on what hardware we need. And as I've been saying, that I probably need to build backup marble machine X's for the tour, and I'm getting quite serious about that. So to be able to build a backup machine, I'm not going to build it. I want someone to build it for me. I need to be able to tell to that person, here is the drawing for a marble machine X, build me one. And that person is going to say, give me your money. And I'm going to say, okay. And I can't order a marble machine X without going back and redoing stuff properly like this. And it's actually really fun redoing stuff with seeing how much I've learned over the way. So, yeah. That's it for now. I hope you enjoyed the spring tension. There was a lot of tension in this episode, I felt. Oh, by the way, a last comment. Don't hate on the visual lifting fingers. They won't sit like this, and they won't look like that in the end. So we'll see in the end how many of you that move over to team visual fingers and how many of you will stay in the team anti visual fingers. They are going to blow your mind once they are in their proper environment, I think. Weekly tips on how to be cool. Buy a cheap caliper, and you will feel like an engineer.